based on the Robin Williams movie of the same name from 1992. I did see this in theaters, and I was just confused by it, as were most people. It's I would say it's a bad movie, but it's so fascinating and so weird and just so misguided and strange that it should be experienced, because it just, like, how did this all come together? Speaking of which, there's a really good episode of How Did This Get Made about the movie that you should listen to. It's pretty funny. But yeah, it just it was a weird vanity project, and I guess it was written maybe 10 or 15 years before it actually came out, so that's always an issue when these scripts are floating around. Usually things don't get made for a reason, and maybe there was a good reason why Toys was delayed so often. So we're just going to watch the intro story here. Like I said, today we're going to be playing more than one game, so I'm going to try to give each game at least 20 minutes, maybe less so with Toys, because it's not a very good game. And something strange I noticed when I was just letting the title screen roll by, it said this game was designed by David Crane. That has to be the same David Crane that did A Boy and His Blob and Ghostbusters and a few other things. I'd be surprised if it wasn't, so I'm just going to say it was him. So there you go. This game has some talent behind it, at least. And you know what? I think David Crane also did Bart vs. the Space Mutants. I'm pretty sure he was on that too, and which is why the opening level has all these weird adventure elements that are kind of fallout after that. But yeah, just some interesting trivia for you guys. David Crane. And I believe this is the only game to actually star Robin Williams, the human Robin Williams. Maybe there's a Flubber game, I don't remember. But yeah, this is Toys. Welcome to the world of Toys. It's terrible. And it's isometric for some reason. And for some reason, I don't know why, but I feel like let's remake this as a roguelike. Let's get a Kickstarter going. The Robin Williams roguelike. It can happen in our lifetimes, people. So yeah, it's just a kind of standard action game. Kind of feels like Smash TV a little bit, but not really. It's hard to explain, but you have different weapons, and you basically use them to take out enemies in a level. Levels are kind of bland, as you can tell by this wire grid does not really inspire a lot of whimsy. I don't know why they went with that idea, but yeah. I'm no David Crane, people. I'm just a regular games journalist. I can't make these decisions. So yeah, like just blowing up bombs, blowing up enemies. Nothing too exciting. I don't think I played this game until today. I might have messed around with it in the past, just, you know, on a whim, like through ROM or whatever, but this is actually the first time I've spent more than a minute on it. And it's, so far, this minute has been well spent. So yeah, like, it's kind of like the movie in that there are a lot of old-timey toys being used as weapons. Which I found strange, because by the time I was a kid and Toys came out, toys were much different than how they were depicted in the movie. They were the old-timey, like, pull-string toys, wooden trains, things like that. When in my day, like, toys were, like, insane action figures and video games and things, so... Yeah, actually, we'll be playing Hook next. We had someone point out that the protagonist of the Hook game is Robin Williams, but it doesn't look anything like him. Until you die, then you turn into Robin Williams, which is a strange fate. Which is now extra sad. I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep this live stream in good taste. And please read our tribute to Robin Williams that we put up earlier in the week. I really liked it. I liked what everyone wrote. And I think we all managed to say something different about it. The horrible incident, that is. So yeah, lots of different weapons. Most of them are kind of useless. And poor Robin can't take more than a few hits without, you know... God, it's even hard to talk about fictional Robin Williams dying. I'm sorry, guys. I'll get it together. So, yeah. It is kind of unfair in that the fact that you are just shot at immediately as an enemy enters the screen that you cannot possibly see coming. I don't like that. But this is Toys, after all. It's not known as a quality product. Oh, and then... That is kind of horrifying. Okay. Yeah, I could ask for a little more power out of these weapons, but I have a feeling that's not going to happen today. I'm not really sure what my objective is, either. I don't know what that is. Okay. I don't know what's going on with this whole safety dance thing behind the behind the action here, this music. And I don't know what that is behind the screen. It looks like a corpse. Oh, is that like... Oh, I think it's actually a weapon, like an elephant gun. Okay. Alright. This should not be labeled Diablo 3. I'm sorry if it is. I thought I changed it. Actually, let's see if I can go in and fix that real quick. Oh, you know what? Okay. Well, you know, it should have saved, but Twitch is undergoing some difficulties now, so you will have to suffer with the lie that this is Diablo 3. Just pretend it's Diablo 3. I think you'll enjoy it more, actually. Yeah, I did listen to the Watch Out for Fireballs or Abject Suffering podcast about this game. I do enjoy that show. I do enjoy Watch Out for Fireballs. They're good guys. I like all their podcasts. Yeah, for some reason, it didn't save the title of the stream correctly. I don't know why. When I went to edit it, it still says Robin Williams Games. So, yeah. Let's blame Twitch. Let's all blame Twitch on that. For that. Alright. I can't imagine having... getting this game for Christmas and just forcing myself to have fun because like these weapons, they just seem to go in random directions, and so we have a duck that goes in random directions, we have a top that goes in random directions, we have a bowling ball goes in a straight line, and a race car that goes in random directions. So three of the weapons are kind of the same in how useless they are. Yeah. Don't worry, we are moving on from toys soon. I had a feeling I was not going to get much out of toys because it is just so monotonous, from the music to the action to the... just not a good game. Actually, I do know what you have to do. You have to take out these cameras in the level for some reason. I know surveillance was a big part of the game, a big part of the movie, rather. Yeah, I don't know. We're gonna have more fun soon, guys, don't worry. Hook is a good game, and so is Aladdin. We'll give it one more try. Yeah, this is not working out for me today. Okie doke. You know, I don't think Absolute Entertainment is around, and this might be why. Really, the era of the bad movie game is no longer around. They're mostly iOS games that are, you know, par for the course. Like, there's no Guardians of the Galaxy AAA, you know, game made by Sega or whatever, but there's an iOS game. I'm pretty sure it's free-to-play, your standard whatever game. So, this is a different era when games are cheaper to make, so you could make a console game based on a movie. Now, not so much. Especially, you know, getting those games to come out on time with the movie are probably much more difficult now that development takes a long, much, much longer to do. Yeah, the toy is an awkward movie. Lots of unfortunate racism. Not one of Richard Pryor's proudest moments. You could see the dignity being scrubbed from his body throughout the movie, so... I've seen it. I've seen the toy, I've seen toys, I've seen Toy Story. Toy Story is a good movie, though. I don't know what's going on with this walk cycle. Before we leave, just check out Robin Williams' walk cycle. It looks like he should be, like, holding a cane or something? It's very strange. Alright, we'll give level one, like, another minute. Because I'm about to go insane from the safety dance going on in the background here. You know, I'm starting to think war toys are better, because the toys I have now are just worthless. Like, what? What is this? Yeah, alright. A very bad game. A very, very bad game. Okay, that did something. So maybe it's all just about spamming your weapons. I don't know. I'd like to be able to do one thing in toys before I go. And those tanks appear to be damn near invincible. Alright, okay. I will save everyone from the tyranny of toys, and we will play Hook next. So let's move on to Hook, which I just discovered is actually a good game. I had no idea it was a good game. Oops. This should work. Yes. Yeah, I had no idea before a recent event happened that I learned that Hook is actually made by the same people who made Skyblazer. And it has great music, great graphics. I kind of dismissed it because even as a kid I knew movie games were probably not going to be good. But this game is pretty cool. I like how it looks, I like how it plays. I really should just play through it all the way. I'm not the biggest fan of the movie, but, you know, I can deal with the game. And it is made by a Japanese developer. And it's actually published by Sony before they got into making their own console games, so go figure. It's a very, very early Super Nintendo game. But still, it looks great. Has like a very, very rich Super Nintendo soundtrack. Just looks really good. And there's Rufio. The characters look reasonably like their movie counterparts. Maybe Robin Williams is a little anime there, but I can forgive that. Okay, I've had enough of the Hook story. Let's move on to the game. It is very swimmy, but you know what? Peter Pan can fly, so I'll let them have that. I also like how you are just sort of disarming the Lost Boys. You're not killing them, which is a nice little touch. I mean, the game could have easily had... Sorry, I'm just taking a small break to turn down the volume on my end. The game could have easily had those characters just blink out of existence or whatever, but they actually went through the trouble of, you know, having a special animation that shows that Peter Pan is not heartlessly stabbing young boys in the chest, which I think is a nice little touch. And I'm not good at this game, but I'll get better. Nice weather effects. Just to let you know you're playing a Super Nintendo game. Okay, so that's what happens when you die in Hook. You turn into fat, old, regular Robin Williams. Whom, they might be overplaying his fatness in this game. I don't remember him being that fat in the movie. Just sort of like a pudgy middle-aged guy. And you can only take two hits. I'm using the magic of quick saves, of course. Let's make some progress in this game. How about that? And that's my bird in the background. He'll be doing some color commentary. Hopefully not too loud, though. He's probably wondering why I'm just talking to my TV. But he's a bird, so... these things are lost on him. I don't like these bees. I don't quite recall the Lost Boy that can control bees. Was that in the original book? I don't know. Okay, so I can swim. Do any of you remember Hook? Do you like Hook? Like I said, I didn't like Hook. It came out when I was 9 or 8 or 9, prime Hook-loving age, but I just thought it was really long and a little boring. Maybe it's time to go back and revisit Hook. Is that Thudbutt? Yes, it is supposed to be this slow. I'm not sure if it's just like... These lavish graphics are slowing down the SNES processor or what, but it is a slow game. So we're gonna get some fairy dust, and we're gonna try to fly. I've never done it. There we go. A really good looking game, though. I approve. with skateboards. Ooh, that was cheap. Let's go back. Okay, the skateboard didn't hurt me that time, which is weird. Yeah, I honestly can't tell if the game is supposed to be this slow or they were just dealing with technical constraints. Sorry, I guess that's the right term for it. But yeah, it's just a very different playing platformer. Ooh, this guy's not. Okay. All right. Way to save right before the guy attacks, Bob. Man. Alright. Okay. Wow, only two hits. That is one anime-looking smile that Peter Pan has on his face right now. Was he known as the Pan in the movie? Is that just a weird translation thing? Like, you are the Pan. I assume Pan was like his surname and it didn't really mean anything. Yeah, there are several versions of this game because the movie was huge. It was a Spielberg movie, Dustin Hoffman was in it, Julia Roberts was in it, Robin Williams was in it. So there is a version of Hook for everything, everything out at the time. I'm sure there's an Amiga version. Oh, nice, he's got like a little Zelda-style sword projectile. So Peter does kill these guys, they're fine. You can kill them. So I take it you're supposed to avoid those beehives, and I'm gonna try to do that. I do like the slow floaty jumps. They are very, they feel very different. They're not like anything I really have played before. Kind of like Mega Man underwater a little bit. I guess it feels like that if you were to make a comparison. But even slower than that. At least Mega Man underwater had like a kind of fast acceleration, but a slow descent. Did Phil Collins do a cameo in Hook the movie? I've only seen it once, I think, and that was, well, over 20 years ago, so. I'm not the Hookmaster. And I don't know what I'm collecting, but maybe it's for points? There was also a cartoon around this time that, I know there are several games based off of that, it was Fox's Peter Pan and the Pirates. It was called that because it aired on Fox, go figure. you know what? Yeah, I don't know which version of the game I'm running. It could be the PAL version, maybe that's why it's slow. Because the original version is slow, but this feels a little slower than it should be. Oh, you know what? It is the European. I'm sorry, guys, but hey, we made it this far. I think I only had the Japanese in the European ROM. on me. I don't know why I didn't have the United States ROM. I'm sure I would not miss anything if... Oh wow, his sword gets degraded. Not cool. Anyway, I'm sure we wouldn't have missed anything if I played the Japanese version, but... Ooh, not fun. But I wanted to at least see what the story looked like in English. Oh, not good. So yeah, in a few minutes, or maybe 5-10 minutes, we'll move on to Disney's Aladdin for the SNES, which is one of my favorite games for the platform. Gosh, I'm just thinking it up today, guys. I'm sorry. This tiny knife is really not giving me a lot of range. So yeah, does anyone actually like the movie Hook? Let me know, because I need to know if it's worth checking out again. It's a long movie. I have to be very selective about what movies I watch, because I have limited free time, but I do like going back, seeing what I missed. Oh yeah, we are watching Hook, the SNES version of Hook. So this boss seems pretty straightforward. Just kind of watch out for where the guy comes out of, smack him. Yeah, I am a spoiled American. I did get the fast version of games, so please excuse my complaints. So was that a boss fight? Nice take on Hallelujah there at the end. Okay, so let's move on to the next level. We'll play a little bit of this, and then we'll move on to Aladdin. That's kind of like the centerpiece of today's stream. I love the game. I made it the header and the thumbnail preview for the article that promotes this live stream. And we'll get into the controversy of Genesis versus SNES Aladdin soon. And there is a controversy. So right off the bat, they are just throwing things at you. Wow, okay. I do like the soundtrack a lot. I need to download it, find it somewhere, because... Actually, reminds me of Secret of Mana a little bit, just with how rich it is. It's not quite as eclectic, obviously, but I do like the orchestration. Okay, how do I get past this? Oh, thanks a lot. I think the Julia Roberts issues are mainly because she was, like, in front of a green screen for the entire movie, not actually interacting with people, as far as I know. It's sort of like the Star Wars issue, Star Wars Episode 1, 2, 3, where a lot of characters are just, like, there's not a lot of humanity because people aren't actually talking to other things. They're just sort of talking to tennis balls on sticks, and, yeah, we'll put the characters in post, don't worry. But it does lead to, like, a lot of woodenness in the performances. Oh, wow. Come on, I just want to jump up there. Alright, we'll try a few things, see how we pass this plant. Oh. It's weird those boulders roll uphill, but I like it. It's actually working in my favor, so... I've only played the Super Nintendo version of Hook. Maybe you guys in the chat could answer Scarrett's question. I'm sure it was bad. I don't know if the same. I really doubt the same team worked on it. I feel like they were like spread out to different teams. As far as I know, I could be wrong, but the SNES one never looked this good. There we go. Yeah, all of these games were published by Sony ImageSoft, which was Sony's publishing brand before they became, you know, a console manufacturer. I believe I believe ImageSoft eventually became 989 Studios, as far as I know. I don't think they're still around though. I mean, they were big for the Sony's first part of Game Day, I believe. Could be wrong about that. So yeah, just very basic platforming. I'm kind of getting used to the flow of the game though. These slow swimmy jumps are kind of like I figured them out by now. I don't know how to get my sword back though. That was a pretty sweet weapon, and I lost it. I lost it after getting hit too many times. Maybe you have to pick up a power up icon, something like that. I wouldn't be surprised. This is a video game from 1991, maybe 92. I forget. There's an apple. Why not? Let's grab that. Even though this is an SNES game, you only really use two buttons, so I feel like developers are still getting used to having eight buttons at their disposal, because you just jump and attack and that's it. There's no perks, no frills, nothing like that. It's just like standard jump and attack. And I can fly soon. Okay, I don't know where I need to fly, but let's get to the end of this level and then we'll move on to Aladdin. Let's move on. I didn't see that guy coming, that's not fair. There we go. I'm sure there'll be- oh, there's no boss, great. Great. Okay, so that was Hook, and for the finale of this live stream, the next half an hour, I'll be playing some Disney's Aladdin. And we'll get into the controversy of, is this better than the Genesis version, or isn't it? First of all, what do you guys think? Which one do you prefer? They're very different games. I think they're trying to do very different things, but I feel that this game gets picked on for some unfair... So a few unfair points. And if you didn't know, this game is directed by Shinji Mikami. He is the guy behind Resident Evil. You know him. He did a lot of Disney games for Capcom before he was allowed to do his own thing. So he did this. He did Goof Troop, I believe. I think he did like a Mickey Mouse game for Game Boy. I forget. But yeah, this is where the Resident Evil guy started. And that's why this game is so solid. I will tell you that I prefer this version a lot. I feel like the Genesis version, there are a lot of games like it. It's made by Virgin Interactive, and I believe, God, forgive me if I get his name wrong, either Dave or Doug Perry, the Earthworm Jim guy. He kind of made the same game about five times, him or his studio. So there's like Cool Spot, Earthworm Jim, The Jungle Book, things like that. They all have very like spindly level designs, lots of like diagonal pathways and like tiny ledges, and they all kind of feel and control the same way. But this game feels a lot more solid. It's like, oddly enough, it's a parkour game, almost, and it looks really good. It doesn't have the same style of animation, you know, the same authenticity of animation that the Genesis one had, but I still think it looks really good. And I know Aladdin doesn't have a sword, but, like, did he really use a sword in the movie that often, guys? Honestly. Not really. And as our friend Jigge says, the combat in the Genesis version wasn't actually that good. It has its strengths, I'll give you that. I just don't prefer to this one. And I think time has proven that this is also a good game. It was unfairly lambasted, I think. And this game also, I think, takes a lot from Prince of Persia. It's like a little more playable Prince of Persia in that you're given a lot more room for error. And yeah, I mean, I feel this game is like one of the best platformers for the SNES. It has a great challenge to it. Not too hard, not too easy. A lot of variety in levels, great graphics, just the perfect length, an awesome final boss. Good stuff all around. Yeah, Mikami does prefer the Genesis version, but maybe he's a little too close to the source material. Regardless, like I would love to see Mikami make another platformer. That would be awesome. I enjoyed the one he made that I know of. I'll get the next one. So you also have these apples you can throw. I'm pretty sure that scarab disappeared. So I believe, oh no boss, okay. Yeah, I mean, it's a very Japanese interpretation of these movie characters. I mean, there are some very, like, little anime touches to these guys, which I like. I mean, like, that's why I like the Simpsons game for arcade so much, because it's a Japanese interpretation of a different art style. So the graphics are kind of like a mixture of, you know, Japanese and American sensibilities, which is an interesting thing that I kind of miss. And yeah, Abu is great in the game. He kind of does his own thing while you're running around. He follows you. Good stuff. Probably the last of the good Capcom SNES. The last of the good Capcom Disney games. If you can think of another one after this, let me know. I know there's Bonkers, but who cares about Bonkers, honestly? It plays okay. I played it. It just kind of uninspired because Bonkers was not. I think we just all kind of tolerated Bonkers. I don't think anyone truly likes Bonkers. You're not going to find Bonkers wandering around Disneyland anytime soon. I believe Goof Troop was... could have been after this. Yeah, that could be the last good Capcom Disney game. It was a weird, like, puzzle platformer. Not platformer, like... weird, like, Lolo type game. Oh man, this guy's really annoying me. Okay. Abu is, like, just frozen in terror when you die. No, Bonkers, the Disney Afternoon show, which was like, kind of like a fake Roger Rabbit style series. I'd love to see a speedrun of this, because I feel like this game is built just to, you know, hit, like, handstand, hand flip, backflip your way through, like, parkour style, so... Yeah, I don't think we'll be seeing the genie in this playthrough. Maybe if I, you know, stop dying. We do have about 20 minutes left, so it's possible I get to the genie level. It's a little too easy, but I think it's, I don't know. I find it, there are just a few, it's hard to describe, but I don't know. It's still a fun experience from front to back. Like, I would just play through it for fun as a kid. Just like, this is a game I can beat. I can, like, play really well at, so I'm gonna just go through the game, get all the jewels I can, you know, do a really good job, and then, you know, in a few hours I'll see an ending, which was not always the case in the 16-bit era. You weren't always guaranteed to beat a game. Now that's kind of like, if you buy a game everyone has to be able to finish it, no matter how good your skill level is, basically, except that, you know, Dark Souls. So back then, having a slightly easy game was sort of a novelty. There we go. Oh my lord, okay. Maybe I'm not meant to go there. Nope. Of course. And I have to go back up. Okay. No problem. Speaking of Dark Souls, these archers are annoying. Yes, I apologize for missing that jump about 5 times. Gosh. Alright, I'm not gonna lose a life to these stupid archers. Okay, guys? I'm not gonna do that. That's not gonna happen. Okay. Taking this more seriously. Hey, we did it. So that's a nice, like, little touch in the background there, Zagrobot Castle. You can tell you're getting close to something. I still have 1 heart left. Oh, and that was a pit. Okay, that's cool. I wanted to start over with all my max hearts, so... we're fine. We're cool. Yeah, I am a little rusty. I used to know this game backwards and forwards. It's also somewhat difficult to talk and answer questions and be good at platforming. That's my excuse. Just hate these archers. Everything could be a roguelike. I wanted Toys to be a roguelike. Actually, the level design of Toys was so random, it did feel like a roguelike. Just like, there's a bunch of crap we threw into a room. Have fun. By the way, wasn't that movie great? That's always a good time. You know what, there's a platform I just reviewed for US Gamer. I wish I could remember what it was. I either reviewed it or just played it. That was really, really good. So yeah, we'll see some new scenery soon. Don't worry. There are 4 city street levels, I think. We're at the boss, I believe this is the boss. Yeah, so the movie kind of, sorry, the game kind of follows the movie's plot in that, you saw that was Jasmine, taking an apple, about to get her hand cut off because, you know, not a very sensitive portrayal of, the Middle East in this game. Or in the movie for that matter, but whatever. So not a hard boss. Oops. Thought it was a 3-hit guy. Yeah, The Thief and the Cobbler is an interesting case. You guys should look it up. It's Richard Williams, who was the main animator dude for Roger Rabbit. Sort of this pet project he worked on for like 30 years. And a lot of it is similar to Aladdin. So much crazy animation, too. So we saw the genie there. He does make an appearance. I do like how he's like sort of like he's assisting with the game. It feels like, which is a neat touch because he is a magical creature, and he's sort of like the self-aware character in the movie. He like understands what he's doing and like his role. So together, Aladdin and Jasmine escape the Sultan's guards and run to Aladdin's home. Blah blah blah. So I believe there was a really irritating dungeon level in the Genesis Aladdin, which is not in this one, thank God. Oh yeah, Mickey's Magical Quest, those games feel a lot like this game, and those are such good games. Especially the first one is so good. The music, great, great games. I need to go and actually play the second two. I really have only dabbled in them. And this level also has great music, and I believe it's just original music. Those great, like, SNES strings. Yes, please. Great music. I will dabble harder on my own time, sir. Yeah, like, I can't talk enough about Mickey's Magical Quest. So good. So much better than it could have been. It was really like a Super Nintendo showpiece for like graphics and, you know, all of Mickey's different costumes. Man, got a Nintendo Power cover. I do like Donald playing as Donald. He's a cooler character in my opinion. Oh man, I want the scarab. I believe you just get a bonus level if you do the scarab right. Let me just do a little save here. Yeah, just moving around in this game feels really good. There's a lot of, like, there's a heft and a weight to Aladdin, and it just feels good to hand plane off things, to swing off them. There's a little Abu. He's excited about something. Oh, yeah. Now, Aladdin should have really dove in like Scrooge McDuck, but he's a chump. Whoops. Skeletons. I don't remember those in the movie. Were those in the movie? I don't think so. I do love the sound of the swords coming out of the gold. They make a nice little cha-ching sound. Here we go! If I play my cards right, we could see the genie's level. I believe this level's a little tougher. Actually, the carpet level is pretty tough. I remember I played through it on a 1UP live stream and I just scraped by on the skin of my teeth. I don't know why my teeth have skin, but I also don't have health insurance, so I can't get that looked into. I'm sorry. Yeah, I really like this era of Capcom music. It's just so rich and great. I love it. I will not stop talking about it. Did I come all this way for bread? Let's see. Okay, that was a mistake. Let's okay. Jump down, throw an apple. Nope, not gonna happen. That was close. Again, Aladdin didn't really do this in the movie, but I would have enjoyed it if he did. I agree, Capcom should make more games like this. Fortunately, making games like this is not a good way to make money anymore, so I'm sure their version of Aladdin would be like a free-to-play Farmville clone or something. Yeah, we'll get to the genie level today. No problem. I can go a little bit over if I have to. I spent most of today working on a greatest flops feature going up in at 3 o'clock. It's about 2Human, and I had to learn a lot about 2Human in my time this morning. Oops. I do like how varied the game is, though. Mikami does that really well. I think Resident Evil 4 is a great example of that. Like, there's just so many kinds of gameplay strewn about in that game. Maybe too many for some people. Oh, great. Here we go. I do like how this is set up. Really cool. And you'll have to forgive all of the quick saving I'm going to do in this next level, because it's hard. It's very hard. I do like how tiny they make Aladdin in this level, though. So, the Cave of Wonders is about to explode. Explode. Oh, I forgot there's this before it, okay. They really get their money's worth out of these small moments in the movie. I believe, like, we're still in the first act of the movie, pretty much. Yeah, I could go for an Aladdin remastered, as long as they don't add, like, 8 hours worth of dialogue that is not really worthwhile on my end, at least. It was nice to hear Alan Young again. What? So this is your classic auto-scrolling stage, which is in the process of killing me. So Mikami's basically using, like, every trick in the book. Like, here's your auto-scrolling stage, here's your... There's kind of like a shooter stage coming up. Like, controls like a shooter. I love the background in this level, though. Just like the parallax scrolling, there's all these levels to it, it looks great. Yeah, Platinum is making an Avatar game, so, the good Avatar, so, you know, anything can happen, I guess. I apologize for the tiny squeaks you may hear in the background. My bird is wondering why I keep talking to no one and not him. Yeah, I'm interested in seeing the Avatar game. I think that could be like a new thing. That could be like a new. Sorry, losing my train of thought. That could be like a new movement for studios. Like, we will work on your properties because everything has to be based on an existing thing now. Just because everyone's so afraid to make new ideas, why not get good developers to make these games? Alright, we're back where we were. Okay. Yeah, we'll see a little bit of the genie level today, no problem. Yeah, I'm glad DuckTales Remastered exists, even though I don't like all of it. I like the remastered music. From what I hear, you can turn the cutscenes off, although I've not been able to in my PC version, so... Excuse me. Oh, that's a bad jump. So I guess they give you some kind of buffer room there to, you can get hit by lava once and not die, I think. Yeah, Platinum is great. I love their games. They're not perfect, but I like the attitude and the meticulous design and just how focused they are on pure mechanics. That would be great. I would love for Platinum to have that reputation. Okay, this level sucks. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to blow into the mic like that. So as you can see, you're not given a lot of room in this level to navigate. You kind of have to hug the right side of the screen, which was much harder to do when overscan would cut off a large portion of the screen on CRT TVs. So I'm going to kind of quick save after every major tidal wave just to get through this. I do want to get to the genie level, so... This is not going to be super fun to watch, but it's a hard level. It's a hard level. Things like that. So, while Aladdin is an easy game, there are stages like this that are not, while they're not impossible, they certainly require more skill. It's no Battletoads speeder bike level, but what you gonna do? What you gonna do? Yeah, Platinum makes the best modern action games, I agree. Metal Gear Rising, Revengeance, whatever they called it. Super awesome, I loved it. I like how stupid they're willing to be, how goofy they're willing to be, rather. Arrgh. We gotta get to the genie level, guys, we gotta do this. He's next. I think we're out of the clear now. Yep, we're good. Okay, now we can get to the genie level. Thank you so much for being patient. Yeah, I take it there are 10 red jewels in every level sprinkled about. So obviously, just art is taken right from the movie, but it looks good. So, this is what I like about this level. It is essentially the Friend Like Me song made into a level. Sort of like how The Lion King did Just Wanna Be King, made that into a level. Although that game was way too damn hard. It was also of the Earthworm Jim style of level design. I believe also made by Virgin Interactive. But this level's just crazy platforming. Nothing has to make sense because it's the genie's world. I love it. Apparently the genie's okay with letting you die inside of his lamp. So much life to all this stuff, like the platforms, they look at you when you jump on them. A lot of detail put into this that they didn't have to do. It was a licensed game, they could have just scrapped it out and made it, you know, fine. Let's just do this. But no, they decided to try harder. Thank you for the pro tip about gliding. I almost forgot that I could do that. Yeah, great graphics in this level. Really good. And there's a genie, he's gonna do stuff. Yeah. Wow. Genie, how could you let me die? I thought we were friends. That's what the song says, right? And there's Abu in the carpet in the background. Very, very cute little touch. Man. Why did I say this game was easy? Okay, well, let's see if I can turn around. Guess not. Guess not! Let's start over. There we go. I do like how the levels start with action, like it's a movie. Or something like that. I don't know how different the Genesis version of this level was. I know there was a very similar idea in that you were playing the Friend Like Me song. Okay, we're doing good. Alright, Genie. Let's do it. Yeah, the Genie does look horrified when you die, doesn't he? He's like, I really took this too far, didn't I? Why did I make my lamp into a platforming level? Now Aladdin is dead. Gosh. Okay. I don't know why this gave me such a problem, you guys. I've had a long morning, though. That could account for some of my poor platforming. I also have a rowdy bird in the background. I'm being so annoying with this, but I just want to get to the end. Thank you, Genie. You did it. So I think that was it. Is there another Friend Like Me level or not? Oh, there is. I forgot there are many of these. Or maybe just two. Oops. Okay. So you can do two things with these balloons. You can jump on them, or you can hang from them, I think. Or you can do both. Very cool. I like that. Okay, let's keep going. I don't know what's up with the flying pots. Just the little wacky enemy design. We are in the Genie's lab, nothing has to make sense. Ooh, gosh. Okay. So yeah, we're wrapping up this live stream, so please make your comments now while you still can. I'm gonna end this live stream after this level ends, or the whole Genie thing ends. I mean, this is a Robin Williams tribute, so I might as well play through the end of the Genie stage. Try not to die too much. Again, that's my bird in the background, I apologize. He's being a little rowdy. There we go. It would be strange if you had to fight Genie at the end of this stage. He's like, I have to carry through this platforming thing to its logical end. Oh, one more stage, that's right. Kind of creepy and weird, but still a funny idea. Yeah, I just like how these stages are just the excuse to throw in some crazy ideas, because they wouldn't normally fit into the standard levels. I do like those springs, they're kind of horrifying looking, but they're cool. The 16-bit age was kind of like a golden age for some licensed games, like Konami did great ones, Capcom did amazing ones. As you can tell here, I like these platforms. I like the little faces they make, really cute. Oops. Oh yeah, make sure to subscribe to this channel if you want to be clued into future live streams. We also have a YouTube channel where everything's archived on, in case you miss our live streams, and they should be archived here. I forget what Twitch's rules are. Actually, I think Twitch deletes things forever after 2 weeks now that they sold out to the man, but you can always watch our archive streams on YouTube. Not bad. Oh, is there a pyramid sec? Yeah, I forget how the levels play out in this game. I don't know what's actually coming next. I mean, they had to improvise a little. I mean, the movie's only 90 minutes. You can't make a level out of every scene. Wow. Okay. You know, I really don't know how I'm supposed to get that that red jewel that's up here. By that I mean the one that's over there. Maybe you're supposed to be able to jump and then float, I don't know, but yeah, this should be the end of Genie, I think. Yeah! Woo, that was a fun live stream, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Let's see what the next level looks like, at least, before I go completely. Yep, it's a pyramid. Who knows why Aladdin is here, was not in the movie, but, you know, who cares. So yeah, thanks so much guys for joining me on this live stream for US Gamer. This has been US Streamer for Thursday. This was the Robin Williams tribute, so hopefully you guys enjoyed some of the games based on Robin Williams movies. At least you enjoyed the